Hey, welcome to another Max 7 tutorial. This is number 27, sampling, record to buffer. Like everyone, I am excited about our keyboard multi-voice synthesizer. And we have got the MIDI. We've got electronic sound. We've got the sampler happening. Little bass. Little jangly. Okay, that's a little crazy. Well, stop and consider for a minute, what else can we do? The answer is so obvious that it's practically staring us in the face. We can record ourselves and then play that back as a version of the famous Beach Boys song, Barbara Ann. Who wouldn't want to do that, right? So, where shall we work today? I'm just gonna move this, whoops, I'm just going to unlock my patcher and move this. I can't quite get it that way. There we go, that, and that, and just move it up and off to the side here so we can work down here a little bit. What do we need to record to a patcher? Well, what we need primarily is a new object called record. So type N and type record. And what is the secret thing that we're going to do then? Well, we want to record to the buffer, Johnny. So guess what we're going to name this record object. You got it, Johnny. Or what you're going to name it. I know, I have to keep saying that. It's tiring. I'll stop someday. Okay, in order to get Johnny to record, there's a couple things we need. One, we need to be able to turn Johnny on and off, and that you can do by sending it the message 1 and the message 0. Okay? 1 is start, 0 is stop. Seems easy enough, but record doesn't have any sound input yet, so we have to put also over here a new object and then just type easy. Easy ADC is the one you want. That's the input. Easy DAC is output. Easy ADC is the input. And then it turns into a microphone. When the microphone's lit up, it's on, and when it's not lit up, it's off. Let's just make sure it's working here by putting, type another new object and just type meter in there, and you'll see the little tilde on there as well. There's our meter, and I like them vertical. I don't like horizontal meters. It's just one of those things. So I'm going to put this here. And then, is that channel 2? Good. Then, I'm going to option click on that and make another one so that I know for sure that there's sound coming in. And my goodness, there is. So, but not in channel 2. That's okay. So, yes, look, see, there I am on the meter coming in, and if I lock my patcher and then click this off, it stops working, and then if I click it on, it starts working again. Great. We have sound coming in, we have the ability to record, and here's Record Johnny, and now we just need a better way than clicking on these stupid things, which makes a lot of noise, to be able to do it. So let's move these guys down. And you may recall that we had used the key object before, so let's just get to it. N, key, right? And then we want to put out some sort of number. I'm just going to type I here so I can see what the number is. We made our computer keyboard into a piano keyboard, and we don't want to mistake our keys for something else. So I'm going to use the, you can feel free to use whatever you want. I'm going to use the plus and equal key to turn on and off my recording. So I can just do it right from my keyboard. So I'm pushing down the plus and equal key, really equal, and that's 61. So now I know what to do. I type N, select 61. Great. If this thing gets a 61 coming through here, it's going to make a bang, and that's going to go right here. Okay. What about the zero? Just duplicate this whole thing. Option click, drag it over here, and then add in here key up. Fantastic. And now whenever we get a key up of 61, it will hit the zero and stop recording. So as long as you're holding down the equals key, you're going to be recording. And as long as you're letting up off the equals key, you will stop recording. Fabulous so far. What could go wrong? Let's see, Johnny, I spelled it right. Everything looks good. I can think of a few things that would go wrong. Well, let's zoom out here. Whoops, that's too far. There we go. And turn the looping, lock your patcher, turn the looping off, because that might be a little weird. And, let's just have at it. Make sure your sampler is actually working. Yes, it is working. And let's go ahead and record. I'm going to hold down my equal sign and just go ba, ba, ba. There we go. And that should have recorded to the buffer Johnny. Let's see if it did. Nice.
Ba, ba.
Ba, ba. All right, and let's just try it with the looping on now and see what we get. Nice. Well, I don't know. Well, I don't know if things could get any better than that, but of course they could. So I guess that pretty much wraps it up. Oh, you know what? There is one little other tiny, tiny thing. That is, if you like something you record so much, let's say we do another recording, maybe Baba wasn't perfect. What would be perfect? this isn't my forte. La 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 la. Okay, so let's just say we really like that when we play it. Oh yeah, I am loving it. Totally loving that. Yeah, I definitely love it enough to save it. What you want to do is save it. The buffer has all that sound now. So if we unlock our patcher and make a new message here called write, and connect that to your buffer, you can now save that. Yeah, sure. And we'll call it la la la. And save it. And then, let's see, we saved it. So now we want to open it. So we're going to read it. Why am I doing this? La la la. Because now, when the buffer actually opens a file, the info object that we discussed last week gets some information on it, and that might help it to play this better when it's looping. Let's just see.
La la la, la la la,
I truthfully can't hear a difference, but that is one nice thing. Now you can write those to file, and indeed, you could even, if you wanted to, go ahead and unlock the patcher, click on this U menu. Oh, I accidentally got a patch cord. Didn't mean to do that. I wanted to click on the U menu, come down here, find the menu items, and then, whoops, I thought you could, oh, well, here we go. I guess we can just type it in there and it'll figure it out. LALALA.AIFF. What the heck? See if it works. So, locking our patcher. You got the cello. And you got the la la la. Nope, you don't. Jongly? Yeah, it got the jongly. Got the bass. Whew, it's not very bassy bass. Why not la la? Let's see. I'm going to remove one F from here. I've noticed that that's sometimes a problem. It's either AIFF or AIFF, and it won't, it's unforgiving. So let's try that. And go ahead and see if it does it. Yep. Okay, more fun than a barrel of monkeys. I'll change it back to this. There we go, and you enjoy yourself with this, and I will see you next time when we take on our next exciting project. Patch well and enjoy your sampling. Take care.